Hi, I'm John Cash. Welcome to John Cash Ministries and Revelations Church's Daily Devotion. Today I want to talk about this. Difficulties will melt away fear in a believer's life. That's right. Going through a tough time will actually melt away fear. And understand this, folks. Fear is the building block of almost every sin that you will encounter in your life. Fear is the opposite of faith. So what we want to be pursuing is faith. Fear short circuits the Holy Spirit of God. When we get rid of the fear, which oftentimes might occur through difficulties, what happens is it allows God to come in and begin to work in a powerful way in our lives. Philippians chapter 1, verse 12, 13, and 14 explains this. The Apostle Paul is in prison. Now, it's house arrest under Roman rule, but he's imprisoned. He's in chains. Now, the Apostle Paul probably had a lot of questions for God. Number one, he was out going from town to town, country to country, province to province, hundreds, thousands, tens of thousands coming to the Lord, huge numbers. And then suddenly, boom, it all ends. He's sitting in prison. He can't do his work anymore. You'd think he'd be going, "What's going on, God?" He had a totally different perspective. He had God's perspective. Take a listen. "Now, I want you to know, brothers, that what has happened to me has really served to advance the gospel." Has he lost his mind? What do you mean, advance the gospel? He's sitting in prison, and he's saying this is advancing the gospel. Understand, he was not seeing things through a human eye. He was seeing his difficult circumstance through the eyes of God, who operates at a totally different level than ourselves. So, this predicament he's in, this tough time he is in, he is saying, "I'm sitting here in prison, and this is advancing the gospel." Now, thank goodness he explains himself, because we all need it. We need to know, what is he talking about? Look at verse 13. He says, "As a result, it has become clear throughout the whole palace guard and to everyone else that I am in chains for Christ." Now, here's what he's saying in verse 13. He's saying, look, it has become clear to all the churches in Asia Minor, in Israel, Greece, Rome, they all know about it. Most likely, we're talking hundreds of thousands, maybe even millions, we don't know the exact number, of people who have heard the Apostle Paul is in prison. So he says here, it has become clear. Everybody knows that I'm sitting here in prison. I'm in chains for Christ. People are looking at it and going, they put him in jail because he's preaching Christ? That's exactly what they did. Now, not only did the known world know about it, but in particular, he says the palace guard. Who are those individuals? Those are Roman soldiers in charge of guarding the prisoners, in particular, the high-profile prisoners. Because remember, Paul appealed to Caesar, and when he did that, he became a high-profile prisoner. Plus, he was the preacher of the day throughout the whole known world. And so the Roman guard heard about him. Now listen, folks, this is important to understand. Though he could not be preaching from town to town anymore, do you think he was just sitting in his house arrest, not talking to the Roman guard about God? You see, the Roman guard were very influential people. These were not the kind of guys to go to church. These were not the kind of guys who were interested probably in the things of God. So God's like, I really want to reach them. How am I going to do that? Oh, I got an idea. Let's go make sure Paul goes to prison. And then they have to sit there and listen to Paul preach to them all the time. God brought church to them. You get it? That's what Paul's doing. Now, in verse 14, it continues, "Because of my chains, most of the brothers in the Lord have been encouraged to speak the word of God more courageously and fearlessly." In other words, he's saying, look, because of what's happened to me, people are looking at what I'm doing, they're seeing what's going on, and they are now being more courageous and more fearless. In other words, Paul's difficulties and his belief that it was better to die for Christ than to live, they looked at that and said, that's exactly what we need to be like. You see, Satan was persecuting Paul, but every historian will tell you worth his salt that when the church is persecuted, instead of actually weakening and shrinking, the church actually grows and is strengthened by the persecution. And so here, he is saying, look, I'm going through a difficult time. I'm okay with it. God's in control. Don't you worry about going through a tough time. You go out and fearlessly preach Jesus. And folks, let me tell you, if we could get the church in America today to go out and fearlessly preach Jesus Christ and to live that Christian walk, not worrying about what anybody thinks, you would see a great revival break out in our country. God bless you. Thank you for your support of John Cash Ministries and Revelations Church.